I'm using a piping cord to do the piping in. The piping cord I'm inserting inside the fabric. The fabric I've cut on a bias cord. And the foot that I'm using is a zip foot, because a zip foot enables you to sew right close to the edge. Now, actually what has happened is I've lost my zip foot and I'm sewing with a very narrow foot, but it's not the actual zip foot. So it does leave a slight bit of a gap. Now, in order to do this, you do need to use a one-sided foot that will sew right close to the edge of the cord and also trap the cord inside the bias cord binding. So we're pushing the cord right towards the end and trying to sew as close as possible to the edge of the cord. The closer you sew against the cord, the more trapped the cord will be and it'll stay in place, because what you're trying to do is to get a stiff edging. So at the moment I'm just doing a straight seam close to the edge of the binding. Once I've done this, I'm going to attach this onto the seam that I've already done, and placing the right side towards the outer side, I'm going to just seam that on top of the existing stitching. So if you lift a slight bit up and you can see the existing stitching, and what you're trying to do, the aim is to sew on top of that stitching. That stitching is our guideline. And you're just trapping, sewing the piping onto the actual neckline piece. Once you've approached the corner, you would twist it around and then sew back up. Lift the foot up, ease it out. Now I've done the same on the outer side and on the inner side. It's a double piping that I will be using. That's what it looks like. It's a little bit, once this is turned over, that's what the end result will look like. Now once that's done, I'm going to pin that onto the dress itself. Now I've already marked this on the center and placing that facing right way down. I'm going to pin it in the center first. Just make sure you align your neckline so the depth that you require. This neckline was slightly bit wider, so what I've done is just attached it just a little bit above, left a piece at the top. Just put a couple of pins just to attach the neckline into place. Once that's attached, we're going to go back onto and stitch on the existing seam on the wrong side this time. Make sure there's no pull or unevenness in your fabric, and just stitch down. The only part on this that's a little bit niggling is your center point. So right to the edge, leave your needle down and pivot the fabric around what you're trying to do is sew on the existing seam that's already been done. Now once you've attached that down, you can cut away the excess. Take out the pins and trim away the excess. Quite a sharp scissor to put to the corner of this seam. Use the point of the scissor placing the point of the scissor right on the corner, snip right into it, making sure that you don't cut the thread. Now if by accident you do cut the thread, make sure you double seam it. Even though I haven't cut into the thread, I'm still going to double seam on the edge of this just to make sure that I don't have accidental cut in there. Once that's done, we're going to turn that over. Now this will need slight cutting and slight trimming down before we, and I think I'm going to go over time, so I'm just going to pause it for a bit here.